Nate Brumley with Dry Fly Innovations, and welcome to this edition of Dry Fly Adventures. This edition is called Cracking the Code. When you dry fly fish, you are constantly having to crack the code. Cracking the code is just a fancy term that Dry Fly Innovation uses that basically all it boils down to is finding the right bug. And it seems like every day it is that you fish, you're always being challenged to try to find the right bug. Today's edition is about putting you inside the mind of a couple of fishermen trying to figure out what in the heck is the right bug. Let me give you a little background about the fishing trip that you'll be viewing in just a moment. It is May the 23rd, 2015, and we're fishing the South Fork of the Boise River. This time of year, there are not a whole lot of hatches going on that river. The stoneflies really haven't started yet. The big stoneflies really haven't started yet. And the caddis have not started either. So basically, it's just a little bit ahead of the major hatches. So we're not anticipating on this particular day to run into anything where we're going to have a whole bunch of fish up at the surface feeding. So we know that we'll be doing one thing a whole lot during this particular day. We will be searcher fishing. And that's another fancy term of Dry Fly Innovations. And all it basically means is fishing outside of the hatch. No feeding fish at the surface, and we're going to be casting attractor bugs to get those fish up to eat at the surface. That's what we refer to as searcher fishing. Now, there is one key ingredient that we know about the river. Before the season started on May the 23rd, we know that there was one big bug hatch that happened that had hatched and came off the river before the season started. That river has a squalla hatch. But you miss it completely because the season is not open during the time that the squallas are actually hatching. What we're hoping for is that the fish will have a memory of that particular bug, that squalla bug. And the searcher bug that we'll be using is an imitation that's very close to that squalla. So we're going to start you out along a riffraff edge along the river, and we're going to be working a searcher bug. So let's go to the river and work a black gold hardback.
It's a lot of water out in there, fish could live. I mean, it goes clear out to the center current, actually. But the fish don't, you know, they just don't seem to be, you know, real active and fast water. You know, not aggressive, not popping right up there and eating. Oh, there he was. That was. Violent. He's a dirty, rotten dog. Jeez, that's a big fish, though. No, wouldn't you know that? Wouldn't you know it? Hey. Just a brawl. Well, now he's in a position where I might get him landed. Maybe.
Hold him right there.
Whoa. Gosh. Look at the color. Look at the color of that dude.
Okay, I got him.
Got him?
Yep.
We'll release him over here. Ready? Oh jeez. He was very unsociable.
That was fast.
There you go. We know where he lives, Jeffrey. That's gonna get about right over him. Yep. That went over him pretty good. Oh, that's a false take right there. Oh, you see, I can see that fish moving in there. Yeah. He's hunting. Big time. See him up there? He's really active too. He's in pretty calm water there. I can probably reach him. He's a pretty big fish too. You ready? I think I can get to him maybe. Yep, that's right on him. He was actually feeding right as I lit, and I didn't quite get out ahead of him. There's another fish in there too. That's on him.
Oh, oh
That was sweet. He just blindsided that thing. That's a big fish too. Oh geez, if he runs at me, we're in trouble. Now if I get lucky here, just really lucky, maybe we lift him up and we'll land him before he gets by me, huh? That'd be good. Oh, you dirty dog. Jeez. Oh, jeez. Okay. He's not all that big. It's a good thing, too. Jeez. He better be. Jeez. That's a wild fish right there. Is that fish is Jeffrey? Wow.
Okay.
Whoa. Cool. Cool.
Man, the way they can blend in.
Oh, geez.
That fish is like, well, I didn't like that experience.
Yeah, he said, boom.
That black gold hurt.
That was just the perfect side swipe, man. Okay, I can almost reach this fish now to the left of the rock. It's a little bit short. Oh, jeez. That is gorgeous. Should be eating that thing.
Oh, God.
I actually nipped him just a little bit, but he didn't eat that thing.
A little helpful hint here. We're fishing a line of water that I refer to as the blue line. The river in this location goes around a corner, flattens out into a riffle, and you can see the soft edge ahead of me that's created on that corner. We call the soft edge against a riffle, we call that the blue line. The blue line is that soft edge for about 2 or 3 feet off of the main riffle. And the interesting thing about that soft edge right there, the biggest percentage of the fish that live in that run of water live within that transition zone right off of that fast current. You'll notice that almost every one of the casts that I'm making here up into the riffle, almost every cast is hitting inside that blue line because that is where the greatest population of fish live within a run of water that would look like this. There's not a lot of fish that are going to venture over into slack water, and there's not a lot of fish that are going to feed out there in really fast water either. Basically, what you're doing is you're focusing your casts in the zones of water where fish actually live. One of my favorite all-time places to put a searching bug is on a blue line.
Like I say, it's kind of a tough wade up along here, but we haven't got much choice. We either wade up there. Oh, fish ate me. I didn't see him. I didn't see him. It probably was a pretty big fish too. It's big fish water. I didn't see it. Oh man, I'm just looking. I'm looking right down it, and I didn't see it. I didn't see it. Sure as hell he was there though, Jeffrey. Sure as hell he was there. Oh, there he was. Jeez, thought it was a little fish until then. Look at that guy. Well, you look at you. Well, you gotta be quick on the draw, Jeffrey.
Got it? Yes. Look at that son of a gun. Whoa. Pretty, huh? Pretty. Ready? Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, I still have no, absolutely no idea. No idea. Oh, there he is, Jeffrey. Jeez. You would have thought so over crying out loud. Jeez. And thing of it is, there's just to the left of him, you can see where that water goes, chop water goes over top the boulder. There's another night, see him? He just rose out there. That one's low, that's lower. We're not quite reaching him yet, but we're getting close.
Yeah, you don't want to bull rush on him.
No, no.
You could miss the lurk. Yeah. Giant.
Yeah, you could. Well, you could just miss this guy that's back in here just feeding in soft water. I don't know why. Jeez. There he is. Well, oh yeah? Oh yeah? Oh yeah? He doesn't look that big, Jimmy? Check him out. Look at the colors in that son of a gun. God darn it. Look at that. Dark. Oh man, that is spectacular. Spectacular. Come to Pappy then, if you're just gonna come down here. Just, here we are in South Fork of the Boise, and we're fishing one of our infamous black golds. That's kind of what that looks like. And this is just a beautiful, shiny, gorgeous South Fork of the Boise rainbow. Just gorgeous fish. Whoa.
He's like, I didn't like that.
No.
So we've been doing pretty good so far on the old black gold hardback, and he's proved to be a pretty good pattern for use today. But we've run into kind of a major problem. The last fish that we just landed, there are numerous fish feeding above where we hooked that particular fish. We've run into a stone wall, is basically what's happened. We can't get any additional fish to eat that black gold hardback. And the only bugs that we're seeing at the surface are really minuscule bugs. There's a midge in about a size 24, and there's a few blueing olives in a size just a little less than a 20. So we are left with a dilemma. We can wade over the top of these feeding fish and continue to fish the black gold in the upper portion of the run, or we can go to the side of the river and change out our entire gear. We're fishing the black gold size 10 on 4X tippet. In order to get down on the small bug, we've got to change out our rigging. So we're left with a choice. We walk over the fish, or we change out our rigging and get down to a small bug that the fish are probably eating. So here's the way that it all unfolded. We know that there's a midge, and we know there's a blue-wing olive. So what we did is we went to the side of the river, we changed out our tippet, got down on 6X, and the first tie-on bug is the bug you see on the screen right now. It's called a caddis. A caddis is a beautiful little imitation of a midge. We tie it on and we serve it to the fish out beside the boulder that you see in the water out ahead of us. We tie on the caddis and we begin serving it to the fish that are feeding ahead of us in the run of water. We get a couple of fish to come up and look at the caddis, but not a single fish eats the bug. After serving it to four or five fish, we're pretty well convinced that they're not going to eat a midge. We flip over then to the blue-wing olive. The blue-wing olive we tie on is what's called a convertible. It's in a size 22, matches the bug pretty well at the surface of the water, and we serve the blue-wing olive to the group of fish. Same result as the caddis. We can't get a fish to eat that son of a gun. We get one false take, and that is it. So we're a bit dumbfounded at this point in time because we have served the two bugs that are at the surface and we still can't get anything to eat our small bug. But the fish are really not, they're not posturing like they're eating adult bugs either way.
We're going to switch to something. Don't know what exactly. How about a caddis?
Can you do that?
How about
a black character?
Black sir, no, it's a small bug, Jeff. I think if you're gonna get him, it's gonna be on a small bug. Yeah, I mean that's just they're just being totally shy. And the other bad part, don't do it. You know, the other thing that's interesting is that, see, the other thing that could be screwing us up is we're trying to cast over the top of them, but there isn't any other way to do it. Can't fish in here any other way, so you're stuck. Caddis it is. Let's try her. Okay, here we go. Let's try caddis. Oh, gee.
Oh, was that on you?
Nope. Well, that's just got to be dead in the middle of them. And they're paying no attention? None. And just see them. I mean, they're acting like it's a damn emerger bite. See, that was a false take at it. That's what that was.
Don't have the right bug.
Don't have the right bug.
Most of the rises that we're seeing ahead of us, and the reason that you're not seeing it on the screen, they're very low profile bites. The fish are very rarely putting their head above the surface. We're pretty sure that it's an emerging bug that they're eating. So here's how we crack the code on this day. Earlier in the morning, there was a small flaw of hatch that came off. There were very few bugs on the water, but that hatch did exist in the morning. I got to thinking that maybe that the fish are eating the emerging phases of that flaw. A beautiful match to that is a bug that we tie called a caddis tantalizer. This is a caddis tantalizer on the screen right now. We're fishing it in a size 18. The flav that I had seen earlier in the day, it was about a size 16, but all of the hatching bugs, especially in the tantalizer group that we tie, they have a little bit bigger presence on the surface of the water. So we crack the code now with a size 18 caddis tantalizer. Here's exactly what happened after we tied on that particular bug.
I'm not seeing what they're eating. They don't seem very willing to eat the now that's like on them. I can't see my bug. But see, that's just right in. Oh, there's some big guys working up in there. But boy, whatever it is, they're on it. Seems real kind of emerger-like, doesn't it to you? And just see them. I mean, they're acting like it's a damn emerger bite. See, that was a false take at it. That's what that was. It's exactly what those fish are feeding on, and you can tell exactly by the way that they're eating. And another thing that might work really well is a tantalizer. Green.
Yeah, because it could be a
caddis. That's exactly right. Strive to find out. I mean, there's no, you don't see any caddis in the system, so you know it's not caddis.
Jeez.
And I mean, they're just not, I mean, they're just absolutely paying no attention. None whatsoever. And I mean, that's lit right in the middle of them, and it's as soft as it can be. Ah, I thought it was me, but it wasn't. He was about a foot to the right of me. Big old damn fish. That probably put him down too. You know what? Oh, there he is. That's a big old fish too. He took that and I didn't realize it.
Yeah.
And he just, I mean, he took it and I was laid on him is what I was. Look at him run upstream. I mean, that's just power is what that is. Red, he's right here. That's a big old gorgeous rainbow. Beautiful rainbow. Pretty. The you know, those colored emergers, they just don't fish all that well on those, on, there he is. Ah, he, you all right?
False take?
No, 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 I had him for just a second. Oh, right in the butt. Oh. I mean, that hook buried right in your butt. I can.
You hooked me right in the ass.
I hooked you right in the ass. I did. I did. And you know, it would have never happened, but the damn fish. He was the reason. Hold my rod for just a second, because wow, that's pretty bad.
Thanks for hooking me right in the ass.
Oh, and not only that, the bad part is no ifs, ands, or buts. I put a hole in your wader. As long as I'm casting, I ain't never gonna hook you. I'm not gonna hook you. But
yeah, setting
the hook, it's just a wild hook at that point. Just a wild hook. There he is. That's another big old hog. Jeez, these fish just got some power now. You know, that's one of the best things I've done. I'm not kidding you. That's one of the best things I've done. Here he comes. He comes right here. Jeez, if I had my net. Look at this thing.
God, what a nice fish.
Look at this thing.
Like a steelhead.
Shh, look at him, look at him. Okay, I'm gonna flop him out now.
Oh yeah, baby. Oh yeah, baby.
Check that out again. Oh, that's gold. That water is
20-inch fish.
That is a 20-inch fish.
Man, that's a brute.
Just look at that.
Look at the beak on him.
Oh yeah, he's just, I mean, that's just.
He's all about it.
Oh yeah. And you can tell he's been through spawn season. See, he's got, you know, scrapes. There's, he's not scarred, it's just scrapes from spawning. But look at that son of a gun.
That's a nice fish.
I mean, that's pretty. Okay, he's going away, Jimmy. Going away. Totally gorgeous.
He said, that sucked.
Keep right on him.
He said, I don't like
Jeez.
That.
We were thinking we were going to hook him on a big bug. Now we're down on 5X tippet fishing a tantalizer, size 18.
The things you got to do to hook a fish.
Oh, ho, 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 ho. Well, that's the beauty. Yes, the beauty. That, when dry fly fishing, they'll always keep you guessing, Jeffrey.
Yes.
That's the way it is. Well, that's right on him. And he didn't eat.
He's gonna be big.
They almost always are.
Oh!
See that guy go sideways to that? Holy cow, he's wild. He's freaking wild. But those fish I hooked this morning, I hooked the one fish, Jeffrey, I tell you, he jumped five times. He jumped five times in the first 10 seconds. It was impressive. But this is not a bad sized fish right here either. I mean, you look at that fish, that's a pretty good fish. I thought it was smaller, actually.
Okay.
Side. See, that's not a bad fish. Just skinny. A little on the slender side.
I got it.
Ooh, okay. No idea where I am. There he is. Jeez. Oh, jeez. I don't really necessarily want him out in fast water, Jeffrey. Check him out. Where are you? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa. He's behind me now. Yep. That's where we didn't want him, but there he went. That one thing about it, they're eating the tantalizer. Come here. Hey, 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 hey. Hey. Cool. Big fish coming out, Jeffrey. Oh, jeez. I don't want to be this high up in the hole, but I can't fish off of those boulders either, so. Anyway, I'm gonna hook a fish right up in there. Look for a rise, Jeffrey. Cause I ain't been seeing it.
I haven't
either. There he is. And they almost look carbon copy of each other, you know what I mean? I'd like to keep this one over here, like this. Yeah, keep his head up just a little bit. You just climb right in there. No, now that's life being easy right there. That's life being easy right there. Check that out.
Okay.
Okay, here we go, Jerry. Here we go. Look at the health of that fish. I mean, just beautiful, beautiful heavy fish. You know, it's got a small head, but look at the guts on it. You know what I mean? I mean, that's some serious guts. Okay, she's going away now. Follow the fish.
The best you can.
Oh, man. Look at that beautiful green color.
So we ended up doing pretty good, and we cracked the code pretty well on this day. But the one thing that we know for sure, there's no guarantee that you're going to crack the code tomorrow. But one of the beautiful, beautiful things about dry fly fishing is just exactly that. You never know from day to day. One fishing day will never be the same as the next. And every day that you go out there, you will be challenged. You're going to have to think, and you will always be daily cracking the code.